secure us.
Confirmed, Juan.
Thank God. Let's go. Sight in. Baby! Oh, yes. Finally, I got the fucking challenge done.
This is not a threat. Not an if, but when.
Is this Makarov or like... I can't tell who we're looking at here, who's walking through. I'm assuming Makarov.
A force of evil who seeks to tear the world apart, piece by piece.
It's gotta be Makarov. Oh yeah, for sure.
To
there's
him,
no way.
Every ally is a weapon. Every bystander a shield. His next target, but we know ours. Makarov.
My Joker smile, you know who the villain is. Just so you remember who you dealing with.
Tomorrow never comes until it's too late.
That's pretty dope. Not gonna lie, that was pretty dope, but I still don't think it's gonna be that good of a game if I'm being honest, guys. Guys, just I'm letting you know, don't get your hopes up. For this game, I don't think it's gonna be good. I think it will be good in the sense that, you know, here's a great way to put it. I think it's gonna be a great game in the sense that Sledgehammer is gonna listen to the community like no other COD developer does, but I also feel like it's gonna be a bad game because I feel like Sledgehammer isn't going to have that confidence anymore after they made fucking, what was it, 2 shit games in a row? But, yeah. I don't know, man. I mean, we'll see what happens, guys. We'll see what happens. I don't really know what to say. Because, hold up, let me look up at, you know, actually, if they're I don't think they made 2 shit games in a row. I think they only made one. Because World War II, I'm pretty sure, was before Vanguard, right before Vanguard. Call of Duty Vanguard, Advanced Warfare, Modern Warfare 3, Modern Warfare 2. Yeah, they would. Yeah, never mind. They're coming off of a really bad, you know, rating. So I think their confidence is going to be a little down when it comes to making this game. I mean, guys, I'm just saying. I hope this game's good. I hope Modern Warfare 2. Yeah, Modern Warfare 3 is going to be good, but I don't think it's going to be. Just for a lot of reasons, I don't think it's gonna be. But, what could I say? Like, honestly, like, I just don't think it's gonna be a good game. I hope it's gonna be a good game. But, like, I'm taking everything with a grain of salt, you know what I mean? I don't know if it's gonna be a good game. But I will say one thing I like is that I'm not saying anything else because I know that's not gonna happen. Or it's gonna happen, or it's gonna be iffy. Like, they're talking about bringing back the classic minimap. That, literally, they've been saying that for the past 2 to 3 CODs. And it always gets cut right before it releases. So, I don't want to believe that yet. But anyways, I will say anything you buy here in the Modern Warfare 2 will transfer over to Modern Warfare 3. Now, I really like that, in my opinion. I think that is awesome, and I think that is a really cool thing to do. Because then we don't have to buy bundles we already have, man. Like, we don't have to do that anymore. It's gonna be amazing. And another thing I hate that they do is that they put Modern Warfare 3 or, like, any game that they're coming out with, they put it everywhere, man. Like, literally, they put it fucking everywhere. Look, you can see it in the top left corner. I bet you, yeah, Showdown Siege. I'm pretty sure this is the Modern Warfare 3 event. That's 2. God, I thought I'd see a lot more. Damn. usually they have it right here where you could see the games. And they have, like, the new game coming out. That's weird. But yeah, I don't know. Let's just play. I'm going to play a little bit. I'm sorry, guys. My brain is very jumbled up. I got a lot of things I got planned for this weekend. Got my graduation party this weekend. And I got a lot of shit going on. I got to wrap my head around. I would clap both of them cheeks, bro. Easy as fuck.
Come on, bro. Come on,
Blade. Come on, Blade. He's trying to hop up. Trying to hop up. The way he was like, "You're not taking my tag, dude!" I fucking just sniped him right in the head. Oh my god! Hey, I'm okay. Oh fuck! Okay, well, there might have been somebody in that building. Oh my god! Shit on! Fucking shit on! Fucking sit down, pussy. Class missing so much. Oh yeah, you trash. Sit the fuck down, pussy. Sit down, pussy bitch. So anyways, guys, I just wanted to say, this is actually perfect that it is showing the Modern Warfare 3, like, you know, don't miss the worldwide reveal in Warzone. I'm so happy they're showing this, because I was literally at work today, watching leaks and stuff about Modern Warfare 3, because I was like, you know what? Maybe it's not going to be that bad of a game. And you know what? From right now, it's sounding like it's going to be a really good game. So anyways, guys, basically what I wanted to do was I wanted to take some time of yours to talk about Modern Warfare 3 and what I think it's going to be like and whether I think it's going to be good or not. Right now, I'm taking everything with a grain of salt. I don't think it's going to be... On paper, it sounds like it's going to be perfect, but we all know that it's not going to be perfect. It might not even be that good of a Call of Duty. And the statement still stands. As I said with this game, it has the opportunity to be one of the best Call of Duty games we have ever seen. You know what I mean? Like, I truly believed that with this game. And yeah, it was nothing to write home about. This game was really shitty. They didn't listen to us. And they completely pushed all of the community feedback to the back wall and was just like, you know what? We're not going to fucking listen to that. Put him in the back room with the fucking autistic kid. And we're just going to keep moving with what we're doing. But anyways, guys. If you guys don't know, Sledgehammer is leading the project on Modern Warfare 3. They're assisting and they're leading the project. They're leading the project. But they're basically assisting the project because the project was already made. And they're just adding stuff to it, if that makes sense. Basically, Infinity Ward is the nerdy kid that did all the fucking work, and then you had the one cool kid that was like, I know exactly what we need to do with this for the project and the presentation so that the teacher will like us and give us all A's. Basically, Sledgehammer is the little cool kid in the corner, and Infinity Ward is the nerd that doesn't like anybody to critique their work. Okay? Let's just be honest here. So basically, from what I'm hearing, Modern Warfare... I keep wanting to say 2019... Modern Warfare 3, from what I'm understanding, is that all the old maps from Modern Warfare 2 are coming, which we all knew that. It was going to be in Modern Warfare 2 for year 2 of the run, but that ended up not happening. They just decided to go with a premium launch of a game. You know, they decided to launch a premium Call of Duty game, which I think they really should have took that year off. But then again, they couldn't afford to take that year off with this shit of a fucking game. Players on this game are dropping like flies, and then once they fixed all the old servers from all the old Call of Duty games, not saying that's a bad thing, I'm fucking happy about that, but it's a bad thing company-wise, because then you have all these people going to play your old games, and is that really a bad company decision, though? Because you are technically still making money, but you're not making your new product look that good. That's a tough one.